Now this question, it says there are three circles C, C1 and C2 and their radiuses are 5, 3 and 2 respectively. If C1 and C2 touch externally, so we have two circles. Which touch each other externally, and then there is another circle C which touches the given circles internally. So we have three circles that touch each other. Now there is another circle C3 which touches C1 and C2 externally and C internally. So there is another circle which touches C internally and C1, C2 externally. We have to find the radius of this third circle. Now we know that in this case, K1 will be positive, so it'll be 1 upon R1, and which is 1 by 3. K2 will be positive, so it'll be 1 by R2, and there'll be 1 by 2 because they touch each other externally. Now K3 is the curvature of the circle that we have to find. And suppose I'll say curvature of this outer circle is K4, and because this circle touches them internally, so it'll be negative. So it'll be minus 1 upon R. So there'll be minus 1 by 5. Now if we use Decartes theorem, I can write K3 as K3 equals K1 plus K2 plus K4 plus minus twice under root K1, K2, K2, K4, K4, K1. So now I'll put the value of K1, K2 and K4. So I'll get K3 as 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 2 minus 1 upon 5 plus minus twice under root. This is 1 by 6. Minus 1 by 10 and minus 1 by 15. So if I'll take LCM, 30. So this is 10 plus 15 minus 6, and this is plus minus twice. And here again it'll be 30, 5, 3, and 2. So I'll get K3 as 25 minus 6 is 19 by 30. And plus minus 0. So from here I can say the value of R3 is 30 by 19. So there is only one circle possible in this case, and the radius of that circle is given by 30 by 19 units.